Welcome to Pollinators in the Classroom, the Great Sunflower Project. My name is Elaine Evans. I'm an extension educator here at the University of Minnesota Bee Lab. And today I'm working with Brooke Nicola, and together we will be presenting information on how you can record a pollinator count and how to add your data to the Great Sunflower Project. We'll start with how to record your pollinator observations.
Hi, I'm Brooke Nicola, and I am the program coordinator for the University of Minnesota Bee Squad's Pollinator Ambassadors program. I'm here today to show you how to participate in the Great Sunflower Project. The Great Sunflower Project is an internet-based community science program designed to collect data on pollinators visiting flowering plants. During the summer months, there's lots of flowering plants that you can choose to do your observation on. But being now that it is September here in Minnesota, there aren't many options available for pollinators. So for the purpose of our project today, we're going to focus on Canada goldenrod, or New England asters are also beginning to bloom at this time of the season. So the things you'll need to participate in the project is a timer. The one on your cell phone works great. A writing utensil, a piece of paper, a clipboard if you have one available, or some other type of writing surface, and a camera in case you don't know what type of pollinator you're seeing or even what type of flower you're observing. If you take a picture of it, you can use later iNaturalist. And there's a video we have linked down below to walk you through how to use iNaturalist. So now that we have chosen that we're going to be using goldenrod today, we need to count how many flowers we will be observing. And with goldenrod, it's a little bit difficult. So to count the flowers for goldenrod, I'm going to count each individual flower on what I'm calling a spike. So I'm considering this a spike. So I'm going to count the flowers on all three of these spikes. I'm going to take the average of those and multiply by all of the spikes on this bunch. So I have previously counted, there's on average 26 flowers. And so I'm going to multiply the 26 by the 30 spikes that I counted here to give me 780 total flowers. So when I was counting the flowers, I only counted the ones that were blooming. You don't want to count the ones that are still in a bud that haven't bloomed or that are dried up. So now that we have the number of flowers that we need, we can go ahead and make our data sheet. So what we'll need for our data sheet is our name, the date, our location. We will put our start time, and we will also put our end time when we're finished, our type of flower, and the number of flowers. Once we have that basic information, we will then make two columns. One column is for the type of pollinator that we see, and the other is for the count or for tally marks of how many of that type of pollinator that we see. Before we begin making our observation, we want to review the types of pollinators that we could be seeing. We have a video on basic pollinator identification, and that is linked also down below in the description. The possible pollinators that we could be seeing today include ant, beetle, butterfly, fly, honeybee, bumblebee, green metallic sweatbee, other bee, and unknown. If you see a pollinator visiting the flower that you're unsure, it doesn't fall into any of the categories I listed, you're just not sure what it looks like, you can take your camera, take a picture, and use iNaturalist to help you identify it later. So I think we're ready to begin our observation now. So I'm gonna write down my starting time, and I'm going to plan to do a 15-minute observation. We ask that you do a minimum of 5 minutes, but it's preferred to do a 15-minute observation. So I'm recording my start time now, and I'm going to be watching pollinators that visit my flowers on this bunch. So right now I currently have one honeybee and one bumblebee. Just seeing a fly come in, and that fly has now left. But my honeybee and my bumblebee are still on here, so I'm not counting them again. And my fly just came back, so I'm going to mark again. Once the pollinator leaves the bunch and comes back, you can count it again. If she moves from one spike to another on the same bunch, it doesn't count again. So my first initial honeybee and my first initial bumblebee are still on this bunch and have only been counted once. And I want to make sure that I know I'm observing all of my spikes.
Here is a quick demo on how to do one of these observations. This is a patch of Canada goldenrod, and we have one wasp that has landed. You can see the long body and long legs. And we are only observing what is inside of the red square. One bumblebee just landed, and we have our first fly that has landed. And now there is another fly, so we have fly two. That first bumblebee has flown to another spot, but she's still within the same observation area. So we just call her bumblebee one still. We have a third fly that has landed and a second wasp that has landed down in the bottom corner.
Okay, time's up. It's been 15 minutes. So I'm going to record my end time here, and I'm going to count the number of pollinators I saw. So it looks like I saw seven honeybees, four bumblebees, and two flies. If you watched your observation, what lasted about 15 minutes, and you didn't see any pollinators, that's okay. That's important data to report too. It's okay to put zeros in there. If the aster was blooming a little bit more today, we could do this option as well. But if we were going to count the flowers on an aster, it's a little bit easier than the goldenrod. So say these were fully in bloom, we would have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for this observation. We wouldn't count any of the ones that haven't bloomed yet. So now that we have our information tallied, Dr. Elaine Evans is going to show you how to share your data with the scientists who are studying the patterns of pollinators visiting flowers. Thank you for contributing to community science.
Next up is how to add your data. To add your data to the Great Sunflower Project, visit greatsunflower.org. You will need to create an account. Once you have done that, you will be able to log in, and you then visit Add Account to report a new observation. The type of count that we are doing is stationary. We were at a single plant for a length of time. We are going to be adding observations that were recorded in the past. For location, you can select your location on a map by selecting New Location and then clicking Next. When you click Next, you'll be brought to this map, and you can then enter in an address. And then we zoom in, and we can select that as our area of observation. To add a count, first you will enter the number of flowers that you watched. This is the flower count from my observation. The plant that I watched was a goldenrod, and we'll get a lot of different choices here. The kind of goldenrod that is very commonly observed around Minnesota is the Canada goldenrod, but you can check on iNaturalist to confirm what type of plant that you have done your observation on. You then click next and we get to adding a count. During my observation, I saw two bumblebees, one western honeybee, which is just the same as the regular European honeybee that we've been talking about. I saw one other bee, and I also saw flies. I saw three flies. It's important here to note, if you did not see any pollinators, you can click the box here. That information is very important. You then add information about the date and time when your observation took place. And how many minutes your observation lasted. So mine was a 5-minute observation. You can then click finish. If you have other information that you want to add to this, you can click edit, or if there's anything you want to change. And then you can have a place here where you can add notes if there's any additions for the observations that you made. I encourage you to double check the numbers reported here along with the observations and the total to make sure that it matches with the data that you collected. Once you've done that last double check, you are done and your observation has been added into the Great Sunflower Project. We'd like to thank the Environmental and Natural Resources Trust Fund for their support of the Pollinator Ambassadors Program. And you can find out more about resources to help you with your observations at blab.umn.edu/classroom. Thank you, and we hope that you see lots of interesting pollinators out there.